welcome everybody back on again, and this time around I'm gonna play me some even more Bastion. For my Final Fantasy 14 stream yesterday, I'm back to streaming it only 3 days a week now. The things I'm doing on there doesn't really warrant me being on every single day, so I cut it down to 3 days a week, and so I'm gonna play some random game the other four. Here I am, and figuring since I like this game so much, figured I'll also give it yet another go. But also, like usual, I'm in the middle of setting up, so just gotta bear with me here. People checking out World of Warcraft. Yeah, I could probably turn that down a little bit. Okay, let's get this chat box fired up. I am gonna have to wear these. I'm gonna take them off momentarily. Let's get that up there. I gotta have a. I have to have the fan on the floor, because this is where I have my controller, down here on the floor, so having the fan down there helps keep my hands cool and dry. Okay, so controller's up and running. So, let's go ahead and get her fired up. Oh, also, throughout the stream, I'm gonna have me a protein shake. Started lifting weights recently, so I'm gonna need to chug like a couple leaves every day. And gonna have some grapes. One more thing, because I'm so forgetful. Okay, Twitch app works. I'm at the final battle right now, I think.
Been meaning to put up some guardrails. I can't hear him at all anymore. He's too far away.
There's that color light. There's that light again.
But he'll be all right. Zolf must be there all alone, just waiting. You know what's funny? Look around. There's not much left to do here in the Bastion, I'm afraid. So why not tell each other stories to pass the time, right? There's another reason I've been telling you all this. There's something I want you to understand. When the kid brings back that shard, the Bastion will be complete.
still alive?
This disease the Earth planted here will go away. What happens to Zulf will no longer matter.
Sure, I'm getting a lot of health tonics. It's like the game actually wants me to be that. Holy crap, these guys suck.
Ceylandia will be whole again.
God damn it!
Everything will be back to normal.
That color
we'll
light again.
Gone. Oh, we're not gonna die. It's more like all of this will just stop. Will go back to the way they used to be. That's the power of the Bastion. This whole place is a living record of the times before the Calamity. The way things were before this story. Be your old self again. Think all those times that didn't go your way. setbacks.
Okay, I'll try that. This worked the last time to get rid of that color line. Hopefully it'll work again.
Imagine if you could have another go at him.
Why don't you heal?
Anyone you've ever hurt? Everything you've ever done, you could do it over. And wouldn't that be grand? Wouldn't you agree? Well,
some bad grapes.
I guess there's nothing more to say.
Marasim. Slazet.
I don't like the hopscotch.
Look, there's something else. A confession.
Luke, I am the father.
How come I know so much about the Bastion? You follow me?
No, not really.
Well, I designed the place, but that's beside the point. There's one problem with a place that sets things back to a bygone time. You can't test it. So you're probably wondering if the calamity happened already. What's to stop it from happening again, after the Bastion does its thing? The answer is... I don't know.
Yeah, I don't either. I don't know either. This is, you know, my first time playing this.
You're wondering if there ain't some other way out of this mess. It's all right. I can tell.
I need to pause the game real quick. Gotta go on here. Need to look at something else too. I'm changing my Twitch tag. Okay, there we go.
But why would you even want another way? Unless you wanted to stay here with us. Well, that's sweet and all, but I don't know if I can stick around. The weight of the calamity, it's on our shoulders. We can't just let it go.
Switch weapons.
Bastion does have another function, strictly speaking. If ever the monument blew out and we couldn't repair it, we could still evacuate. First, we'd round up as many folks as we could carry. Next, we'd detonate the cores, and we'd take off away from here.
I don't get it. Yeah, I'm not liking that battering ram.
You know, Zolf and his countrymen won't be giving up that shard without a fight, don't you? Zolf and the Ura. All they want now is to see the Bastion fall. Zolf dedicated his life to a lasting peace between the Ura and Ceylandia. Imagine the city would try to wipe the Earth out. Zolf ain't lost every shred of decency, though, has he?
Apparently she's immune to damage.
This ain't a personal matter.
What the fuck? I'm trying to do my... This is why I don't like the battering ram. Because as long as you have that, you can't do anything else. You can't move. You can't move, you can't roll out of danger. That's what I was trying to do earlier.
It ain't a simple matter of pride either.
doesn't hit a single one of them. Got me a moral choice. I'm not even sure which is worse. I hate the battering ram, but I'm not sure what good Zelf's body's gonna do me.
See it now. The kid in one corner, then Zulf in the other. Ain't much of a fight. Don't you worry, though. Once the Bastion's restored, it'll all be all right.
Now, I'm assuming that
you ain't
because
still
there's no combat, because I got a body that I'm basically can't fight at all. There's gonna be no more combat here, but apparently not. Potions left. So I'm guessing this is gonna be a game over.
Kid's probably dealt with Zulf by now. He reminds me of myself when I was his age. I ever tell you about those days? Hey, kid. Get up, kid. Come on, that ain't funny. I say get up. That's more like it. Set that shard into the monument there. Then we'll talk. The Bastion. It's finally finished. Now, there's something I want you to see. Welcome to the heart of the Bastion. I ain't one for long goodbyes, so here's the deal. Zia and I figure you've done the heavy lifting, so you get to do the honors. We can tell you how to work this thing if you got any questions. Hey, kid. Don't let anything you've done get to you. You could save all those creatures here and now. You've got one thing left to do, so you hang on to that badge. Besides, you earned it. Zolf only brought more ruin to the Ura. No wonder they didn't take kindly to him. Always wondered what the Motherland was like. Not that it matters anymore. You can undo the calamity here and now. Go on, kid. And before I forget, thank you.
You made it. When I finally found my people, I told them we could help. They just took me for a traitor. Glad you showed up. Zolf tried to talk me into joining him. I tried to talk him out of it. I guess we both failed. If I could be any place I wanted, I'd stay right here. We could go anywhere in the world. So, let's see. You can either prevent the calamity, or stick around with me and Rux. I'd hate to be in your shoes.
Okay. So I got a couple moral choices here then, huh? I gotta face a pretty tough call here. Now, as far as game mechanics go, I'm thinking if we evacuate, there won't be a new game plus option. But like I said, this is my first time playing this game, so I don't know if this has anything to do with that. Well, one of the reasons why I'm still continuing to stream this game is, I found out that there was a new game plus on here. So, that being the case. I'll talk to these guys.
Just go with your gut. You'll do the right thing.
Ready to get this over with?
Storing it.
It's finished. Now, sit tight. It'll be over soon.
Cool advice from Rux. Just go with the gut. That was the first thing I had in mind.
No matter
storing
what
it.
Happens next.
I want a new game plus.
I suppose all that's left is to try and remember this moment. The Bastion's gonna take us back to a better time before any of this. Might be we'll forget everything you've done and each other. though, after all we've been through. I find that hard to believe. So long, kid. Maybe I'll see it in the next one. Ceylandia, we're coming home.
Like it. Logan Cunningham, I had never even heard of him. I like it when he used unknowns as voice actors. Stick around and check out the artwork. Forge too, huh? Didn't know that. I guess, while these credits are rolling, I'm gonna put my grapes back in the fridge. Way to speed this up either. Not too sure on this. I think I might actually be forced to sit through all this. I guess while this is going, I'm gonna switch over to my browser. I'm gonna Actually, I guess what else I could do too is type this down. Yeah, I guess this game goes back a little while. Okay. Score attack too. So, looks like they kind of have their own little adventure mode then. Score attack.
I'll see you in the next one. Proper story is supposed to start at the beginning. Ain't so simple with this one. Now here's a kid whose whole world got all twisted. Leaving him stranded on a rock in the sky. He gets up, sets off for the Bastion, where everyone agreed to go in case of trouble. Ground forms up under his feet as it points the way. He don't stop to wonder why. Finds his lifelong friend just lying in the road. Well, it's a touching reunion.
I'm gonna have to
what's left of the rippling walls. Years of work undone in an instant. In the calamity. That a survivor? No, ma'am. It's a gas fella. Forced out from underground. Kid pops him good. Starts to feel his bruises, though. An old repeater falls out of the sky. Ain't a gift from the gods, but it'll have to do. Kid's worked up quite a thirst by now, so that fountain looks real inviting. Sometimes you just need a drink. Kid finds a memento from a girl he knew. Always used to fancy her. A school of squirts tunnels up around them.
Oh, I gotta do something. Hang on, brain fart. Damn it, I'll be back. Forgot to grab some coffee.
He sets foot inside one of Selandia's famous watering holes. Wait, haven't I? Anyway, Ronnie's place just brings back memories. Then Kid finds his trusty shield. But just as he's getting a handle on it, the security takes him for a petty thief. Shield saves his hide. Windbags start turning up for last call. More squirts start coming out of the woodwork. Big old fella pops out in front of the kid. And windbags are playing for keeps. Kid sees the way to the bastion out the window. He gets a good look at things on his way down. He lands on top of a breaker's bow, and it ain't broke. Kid spies a good perch for some target practice. He knows he should draw the string all the way back. Right back at ya. Good news is the emergency defenses still work. Bad news is they're aiming for the kid. Picks up a few pointers from a dusty old tome. Fast learner.
Yeah.
He finds the distillery right next to the arsenal. Tough part of town. One sip of the spirits in that distillery, and the kid'll feel like a new man.
Cole, everything's unlocked. Doomshine? Champagne? That's just simply hitting them. I don't think I'll need that just yet. And I'm guessing that only works like one time, or there's probably like some kind of cooldown. Otherwise, that'd make me immortal.
The arsenal is where the kid can pick the best tools for the job. Some of them squirts birthing like crazy in a couple of corn bins. Ferry barge sends the kid on his way. The Bastion's real close now. To his death. I'm just fooling.
Ball.
Kid takes a chunk of alloy. Smell of barley and spoiled blueberries fills the air. Scumbags. Kid maybe shouldn't have done what he just did.
You're only gaining 1 point of health for each shit, so.
Kid puts him out of his misery. He steals the city's heart. Might as well. Kid has a feeling he better get a move on. See, that core Kid took was the only thing making this particular rock stay afloat. Kid just keeps running. Somersaulting like crazy. At last, the skyway is in sight. Whisks him where it needs to go. Now the kid sees something stranger still. His mind races. Did anybody else survive? Sure enough, he finds another. He finds me. We talk for a spell. There's a bit of the Bastion's power in that crest. Enough to point the way to the cores. All I tell him is to set that core of his on the monument there, then watch. I try to let the kid down gently. This is the Bastion, all right. Except no one else showed up. And just like that, the Bastion comes alive. Starts growing again, growing stronger. Kid's gotta put its power to good use. Now the Bastion can send him even farther into the wild unknown. Kid ponders what to build.
Yeah, Leech ain't that great, so I'll just go ahead and fetching fizz on that one. And you gain hardly any health at all for counter-blocking, so.
Cinder brick style sure goes down smooth, then stays in your gut like a rock. The kid don't know what's out there waiting for him. The Skyway. Now the kid can ride the wind to distant lands. I'll see you in the next one. Proper story is supposed to start at the beginning. Ain't so simple with this one. Now here's a kid whose whole world got all twisted, leaving him stranded on a rock in the sky. He gets up, sets off for the Bastion, where everyone agreed to go in case of trouble.
Oh, that's right, I can repeat all these. Yeah, so this really is like adventure mode.
Now he lands at the intersection between bad and wrong. Ought to be a core down one of these twisted streets. But which one? Up north is where the gas fella foreman used to live, tending to his flock. Gas fellas all dress alike. Kids wondering the same thing. And there it is, but it's locked down tight in an alloy cage. Blustery old foreman is keeping his fellas in check, almost like he's showboating for the crowd. There's a new marshal in town.
Damn, that was quick.
He hears the whole place groan, but it's too tough to follow. Might as well check the other side streets before leaving this hole. He comes back, just like I knew he would. The core hums in his pack. The monument's calling for it. Kid does it again. Only fair he decides what we build next. The windbags used to be all right. Then the Calamity took the floor out from under him. A lot of things need fixing up in this world, and we can start right here. Kid's lifelong friends looking fit to keep on fighting. Picked up traces of other cores while the kid was out.
Oh, excuse me.
In better days, the melting pot was sealed tighter than the skin on a squirt. Stuck inside one of those fancy cages. Some of the stuff lying around is downright dangerous. Throws a switch. Now what could possibly go wrong?
Everything. I'm sure Murphy probably came along
quite a bit,
right?
As it turns out. The cage starts lifting from the core ever so slow. All Kid can do is wait. Shipments start falling in. Squirt's born bad. Some spring to the kid's defense. Judging by the movement of the cage, it's gonna take a little while. Territorial around the core. Then a shipment of free samples shows up. It ain't all bad, as the kid finds some spices from the motherland, tax-free. One thing's for sure, that cage is awful heavy. Yeah. left, and the core goes free. 10, 9, 8, 7, give or take a few seconds. Finally, the core's within reach. And done. Barge.
Damn. Good place to rack up your score.
I still remember the look on his face after that one. The old world's finished, but the new world's just getting started. The Calamity saved some of my old books. Guess it's got a sense of humor. Folks voyaged across the boundless sea to found Ceylandia. It was good living here for a while.
Can I read them? Can I read them? I don't know what's going on.
Never would have pegged the kid as the bookish type.
This must be one of those new ones. You don't get this one on the first playthrough.
You don't get to be my age without learning a thing or two about what's what. But the most valuable lessons come early in life. Still like to read from time to time. It covers the important things, and it manner of speaking.
Wrong button.
Here we go. A is for Kobe, the goddess of oath and abandon. Make a promise, and the chastened maid will hold you to it.
Pretty much gonna call this game over.
Still with me.
Out of there. That's exactly what I was trying to do, too. I was trying to make those red shots at one of the monsters. Maybe the monsters will go after the towers instead. Okay, apparently I got a machete.
Bastion's a place of peace, but we can hold our own if we have to.
Okay, I thought I did. Trip mine, I don't... What's that one? Gel canister.
Seen a lot of strange before, but this takes the cake. Ain't much kid can't handle with hammer and bow in hand. Some things just ain't meant for this world. But who are we to judge?
I
Fetching fizz is like a mouthful of nails, but the benefits are worth it.
So the way I'm understanding this, I could theoretically rebuild my entire Bastion just by running the same one over and over and over again. Yeah, they really made an adventure mode out of this. I think I might be playing this game a lot more now. That's probably one of my favorite things about Diablo 3.
Couples used to walk the sundown path. Kid ain't here for pleasure, though. But then, somebody gets to the core before the kid. The floor starts giving way under the lightest step. A single panic squirt can bring the whole place down. The fragments of the old world rain from the sky. Well, the path ain't exactly open to visitors anymore. Quick and careful is the only way to go. See, the path was intended for leisurely strolling and such. Sky bridges link the path together. One of them bridges whips the kid along. Air travel always was an iffy proposition. But calamity changed everything. Even where the wind blows. Well, if we mastered the winds in the old days, we can do it again. But the question is, who else could have taken the core? Well, ain't no survivor stole the thing. Scumbag ate it by mistake. Tough break. Unlike the kid, that core ain't coming back. Ship live munitions down the path.
Yuck.
He's wise to toss those things plenty far away.
Yeah, that's pretty much all I'm gonna have to do it.
Even gas fellas need some shut-eye from time to time. They get real cranky when they wake up.
I don't think I even got the core.
Kid keeps coming back to an overwhelming question. Who else could have survived the calamity? So he didn't find the core that time, but that ain't about to stop us. The dead. The dead ain't gotta worry about this mess. The calamity took everybody after all. Kid sees it plain, frozen faces all around. These folks never saw the calamity coming, but someone did. Someone close. It was someone like him. Something so familiar about that man. It's a snag or two trying to get to him. He ain't about to stop, no matter what. He's got so many questions after all. Just ain't got time for answers. The Tundra brothers didn't make it. They never saw what it was like beyond the walls. Nor did the bird boy. Didn't make it. The Jawsons, they didn't make it. Grady Sr., Grady Jr., they didn't make it. But him, he survived.
Who's him?
Kid finds proof enough that man ain't from around here. Just think, without that man, we wouldn't be here right now, would we?
Okay, so maybe hand grenades aren't so bad after all. Last game I played with those, it's just they're a bitch to aim with. Guess I just now realized you have to actually lock on to the target first before chucking them. That being the case, I just might have found my replacement for the, that galleon cannon.
The core survives as well. Kid does what he has to do. And then... What do you say to a man who's seen too much? Kid hasn't a clue, but he says this. We have to go. Please. He's a proper gentleman, that man. His name is Zulf. No hiding, he's an Ura. Folks like him ain't never been a common sight in Ceylandia. He's relieved to see a living face or two. The kid and I introduce ourselves in kind. Both to him and to each other for the first time. For Zulf, Ceylandia was like a second home. He's real worried about his first home, too. Far to the east. We all lost loved ones in the calamity, he says. I don't know how I'm gonna go on without mine. He was born in the Tazzil terminals. The Ura sent him on a mission of peace to our city, and he's lived here ever since. You show me whoever made this, Zulf says, and I'll show you a scientific genius.
Something tells me I'm not supposed to use that.
We fought the Ura decades ago, but that was then. Things are different between us now. The Corps, they remember. That's why this place is coming together. That's why things are gonna be all right. Well, look what we have here. The lost and found. Here, kid takes fragments of the old world.
There we go.
Makes them whole again.
Okay, all it takes is
fragments, and the Bastion makes it good as new. Zolf offers to help me plot the skyways for the kid. At least the calamity hasn't touched the stars, he says. We could always see the stars. We just never could reach them, no matter how high we built.
Let me, okay, so I have the war machete now.
Machete, every bit as effective as the fancier stuff. Ain't never letting go of his old friend with a sturdy grip like that.
That's good to know, too. That means this, the blue shard cost is only a one-time fee. You can switch back and forth, whenever you need to.
Zolwood oil and that blade shines like a light. We tracked down a couple more cores near the edge of the city. Windbag Ranch was built for gathering squirt extract and copious supply. Ain't nothing more healthful. Some folks showed up to make a fast buck with nothing but a knife. Slippery little devils. Place gets awful slick sometimes. Still others use the place to test their finest blades.
Yeah, that sucked.
Kid comes back from Windbag Ranch smelling good and ripe.
Good to know. Got a ways to go.
There's only one way to send a brick forth. Sure, the city marshals may be gone, but now the force crawling on the mags. The calamity was mercy.
Hey, what's up, White?
The windbags ain't so lucky.
Gotta counter this guy. Well, if you like, I can start over.
They've been left to freeze or starve or face the kid.
Well, I guess, one thing about this game, there's kind of a God of War aspect to this.
Wham! Kid's ready for the windbags this time.
And if you put up your shield at just the right time, like, just before the guy hits you, it'll be a counterattack, just like God of War. God of War worked the same way. But, I beat the game recently. You can tell in the lower left corner there, this is score attack mode.
windbags, young and old, keep fighting for the fort.
Boom!
Good thing the windbags don't know. Kid's fresh out of health tonics.
This is the weapon I'm thinking of. Scrap musket. I'm gonna be using the
something
living hell out of this.
Just
one.
Can't handle. Something that'll punch clean through their greasy hides.
Hard to hear of it? I was just Oh god, where was it? What are the YouTube videos? There was what are the channels called? Extra credits? One of their video series is called Games You Might Not Have Tried. And this game here was on that, and it just, the whole thing has a real southern style feel to it, like if you can tell by the voice actor, got kind of a low southern drawl kind of voice, that kind of thing, that kind of turned me onto this. Secondly, he's referring to him in the third person, so it's kind of a totally different type of narration, something I never heard before. And then, plus the artwork, too. Yep, it's the one.
Bags ain't much different from normal folks. All they want's a warm place to stay.
This is probably gonna be my main weapon right here.
The calamity drove the windbags topside. A lot of them wound up here in this very fort. Windbags can't use martial supplies, but the kid sure can.
Yep, like I said, I'm gonna be making heavy use of that one. Gel canister, this is something you don't get until after the game. After you've beaten the game.
As for the windbags, Cinderbrick gave them enough heat and metal to munch on for a while. Well, the fort ain't theirs by right. Can't blame them for wanting it, though. so many of those sorry things holed up inside that old fort. Not a scratch on him as he presses on the higher ground.
Hey, it just hit me. These are, portal turrets. Huh? Nice little reference. You do it at the right time. Nope. Like I said, if you block at just the right time before the monster hits you, you'll do a counterattack that goes right back after him, right back at him. Like that.
Its stash of grenades is there for him if things get even worse. Secured his plane gone haywire. In bags gummed up the works.
Yeah, something else I like about this game too, the music. Again, it's like really unusual for this kind of game. Like kind of a country bluegrass feel to it. Some Arabian as well. I can't get too close to those.
Kid ain't afraid of getting burned.
Huh. Yes, which is why I'm shooting at these things from a distance.
Trap the kid in the middle of the fort's parade grounds. Kid's blasting everything in sight with that newfangled musket. Then they bring out Glutus and Glandon and all their scumbag uncles. They got something to gain, and only their sorry hides to lose.
Oh,
kid takes down Glutus. Maybe it was Glandon. Go out with a whimper.
And I guess another nice little thing about this game. Gotta hit the X button constantly, but like God of War, you can just keep doing this. Except in this game here, you can actually do it faster.
Kid used to dream of getting a Marshal's badge, but not like this. And now ain't nothing left for nobody down at Cinderbrick Fort. Kid shows up just as Ulf's telling me about his own journey to the city. Seems the only thing the Calamity saved for Ulf was a smoking pipe.
Mm-mm. That area sucks.
The Marshal seemed like a good man, he says. They treated him with dignity. Zulf brought his antique smoking pipe all the way from the terminals. Zulf's travels ain't much compared to what the kids had to go through for all this. Kid can pay respect to the old world and earn it in kind. The valediction. Just another one of my sketches. Nothing more.
And then here, this is where you unlock achievements that'll give you money for a reward.
Words can't express what happened, but they're all I got. Even since the Ura surrendered to us, the Marshals kept a wary eye on him.
And the distillery here? This is where you get all your passive abilities. I'll certainly want that now.
If you're feeling low, count on the buttery flavor of our own Bastion bourbon.
Okay. So let me switch over to here. Gonna break off for a few. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and break off for about 5 or so minutes. Gonna head to the bathroom and gonna get me something to eat while I'm up as well. I'll be back. cross that off. Okay, and I'm back. And just gotta have me some red wine vinaigrette salad. And a Reese's Ghost. It's basically a Reese's peanut butter white chocolate. And then a Three Musketeers bar. One for now and one for later. Oh wait, that's a hammer.
War machetes are so quick, you gotta keep a good grip on them.
Gel canister. Oh, I remember that one. Works great, but on the downside, you can't attack.
Anything survives a musket shot ought to be quick work for that blade. Finders keepers. Tune a scrap musket, you start with the barrel.
Yeah, listen here. This here is more of a choke mechanism. Widens the spread but shortens the range, and then this one here, vice versa.
Kid collapses after just one drag. The past. Only good thing ever come out of the past. It's history. Catches up with the kid. Hardly had a moment's rest since all this started. Fair to say he's led a hard life. Supposing what he says in his sleep ain't no lie.
Trying to do.
He never knew his old man, but he had his mama to take care of. Frail thing with pure white hair like his. His mama's heir to the kid no favors while he was growing up, but he learned to hold his own out there. School ain't working out, so the kid signs up for a turn on the rippling walls. Make his mama some money. Thanks to folks like the kid, the walls kept Ceylandia safe from whatever's out there. The elements, the Ura, you name it. Once the kid done his time, he hurried on home. Turns out his mama's time was done too. The city had nothing for him. The money he'd been sending home was nowhere to be found, either.
Oh, nice. Basically doing a 15-hit combo.
So what'd the kid do? Why he went right on back to the walls for another 5 years? In the history of Ceylandia, nobody's ever volunteered for a second shift on the walls.
Oh, fuck that up, big time.
Kid earned good standing with the marshals. They trusted him to scout out farther than anybody. Shuddered, cracked, and split apart. Saw nothing where the world used to be. The calamity happened just like that. Kid had to work with was his hammer and the clothes on his back.
Bullshit.
Twisted streets, he ran with nothing but the city crest and an old stranger's voice to guide him. Thank you. finally arrived at Ceylandia's vaunted safe haven. He and no one else. But then, all he got was more thankless work from a man who ain't even asked his name.
I had a feeling that was gonna happen.
Anyway. Sure, I may be the one who dreamt up the walls and the bastion, but the kid made him real. Not me.
Long wait.
I'd like to say I'll never forget him or what he's doing.
Did it.
What he's done. I surely would.
Did it.
It wasn't fixed, it was unbroken. Points just don't get any sharper than that.
Yep.
The accused always got a fair shake in Ceylandia. Some used to take the bullhead trial. Survive the trial without taking a scratch, you'd walk away a free man. trial taught folks three things. First, a good defense is a good offense. Second, you gotta always watch your back. Third, ain't no godlike bull up there gonna save you.
Can I counter some hits, please?
Smarter ones knew when to just step aside and let things go. The kid pulls through in fine form. The kid makes it out in one piece.
That's it, huh? $500 last I counted.
Well, the kid always wanted to compete in the Bullhead trial. The gods, they're all undone. Folks used to make pilgrimage here to pay their respects to Pith, the bull. Well, the gods are long gone now, and the Orchard Core is long gone too. It stood for something once. Something real. In time, though, the bull stopped being a symbol and started being decoration. Pith makes a decent scarecrow, at least. Then Pith lights up like a rodeo. Punching through his hide.
There we go.
Must have been guarding that shrine. So what'll it be? Invoke the gods, or tell them off?
Probably gonna tell them off. guessing this one here. They blow up when you kill them.
Messiah.
That's it, huh? Extra 5%.
You drink. A Kobe.
So I'm guessing these are all just an extra 5%.
Kid decides to press his luck. But if the gods are alive, they must be plenty sore.
Yeah. They explode when killed.
Kid ain't never seen windbags that quick. Maybe old Pith put a scare in him.
I forget to regenerate.
Kid passes Pith's trial, and he's richer for it. The gods don't care about trinkets, but the kid ain't no god. Kid ain't found a core, but at least he found Zulf's precious shrine. Zulf doesn't touch the thing. Says the god of commotion is no children's toy. Liura feared the gods. We turned them into toys, put their faces on our walls. Justice. They seemed unstoppable.
Should have been in here.
Folks used to make pilgrimage here to pay their respects to Pith, the bull. Well, the gods are long gone now, and the Orchard Core is long gone too. Seems Pith ain't much of a watchdog. The gods don't care about trinkets, but the kid ain't no god. Pith stood for something once. Something real. In time, though, the bull stopped being a symbol and started being decoration. Pith makes a decent scarecrow, at least. Then Pith lights up like a rodeo. Ain't easy punching through his eye. Kid breaks into bits. Must have been guarding that shrine. He can't just leave without checking out that shrine, right? So what'll it be? Invoke the gods, or tell them off? Lamain. Kid decides to press his luck. Well, if the gods are alive, they must be plenty sore. Kid ain't never seen windbags that quick. Maybe old Pith put a scare in him. kid passes Pith's trial, and he's richer for it. Kid ain't found a core, but at least he found Zulf's precious shrine.
Yup.
The Langston River flowed free and wild till the Calamity drank it all up.
All this
water just grew wings and flew off. Riverbanks swarming with windbags. They're so bent on finding the core, they hardly notice the kid. Lucky for him, a certain famous ferry barge is still afloat. Send some squirts crying home as she leaves port. Maybe Nelly knows the way to the core. Maybe she can slip right past all the clamor on the coast. Or maybe not. The security skiff pulls up portside. Nelly's just another windbag of those guns. Just then, the windbags notice who she's sailing with. They're pretty steamed about what happened at Cinderbrick.
What, look at all these shots I'm countering.
They try to cut her off. They try to slow her down. Try to knock her out.
What?
Oh. Well, Weepin' Nelly tries harder. Try as she might, though, she hits a snag. Kid's gotta help her get untangled. Favors for favors.
Yeah, I gotta take those out. They hurt you if you touch them. Yeah, it's gonna blow him up.
At least she picked a good spot for a break, because the core's right there. Thank you. They had their own eyes on the core. But why? Well, kid ain't got time to think it over just yet. He finds Weepin' Nelly rare to go. Turns out she's got a special surprise for when the waters get rough. She's gonna need a little help with all the pickers. Traffic things think they're king of the roost now. The rest of us only wish we could fly in times like these. Security's gifts keep on coming, starboard side. Don't seem to care what they shoot, long as they hit something. To remember this next part.
Definitely gonna be my last run here.
Used to take an enterprising man or a plain old fool to venture out that far. The city was the most beautiful place in the world. We all knew that. But on the other hand, some folks just yearn to see the things they're told they can't. And that's why you go to Prosper Bluff. There, the kid hears something he ain't heard in a long while. How's it go again? Sorry to interrupt. That's the one.
That wall is gonna fall. Build that city
damn it.
Well, no point explaining what happens next, right? Suffice it to say, kid ain't coming home empty-handed. And besides, it's like the song goes. They'll be here before too long.
Yeah, I'm just gonna be the last one right here.
We darn near celebrated when the kid got back, didn't we? Zolf never thought he'd see a fellow her again. We become fast friends. Calamity has that effect on people. But there was more to be done. There was one last core to find. Most of the Ura never got a taste of Ceylandia's fine goods, unless they were born and raised in the city like Zia here. Sure, the world's all gone to pieces farther than the eye can see. But leave it to this gal to point out the amazing view. Girl tried to run away from home one time, but the marshals stopped that, didn't they? So many secrets in there and she can't even read it. Her father's own journal. Go on, open it, she says. The worst that can happen already did, right?
Location unknown.
He ain't all that shy. If only I'd known half the secrets of the Calamity were tucked away in that book, I'd have worked a translator right away. A scientific journal written in Zolf's native tongue. He learned so much from it. Too much.
Whoa.
Kid surprised when I tell him there's only one core left. I shouldn't have believed it either.
Yes, that's it. Nope. Still haven't leveled up. Okay. Alrighty, I'm gonna go ahead and call it good here. I gotta work tonight, so I'm gonna have to get ready for that, and plus I need to get a nap going and all that. But good time playing this game today. And maybe come over the weekend. I might play it again. I don't know. We'll see. But yeah, that'll do it. And tomorrow ought to be Final Fantasy 14. And I should be up at my usual time between 4 to 6 p.m. U.S. Central. But until then, thanks for coming, everybody. And see y'all next time.